Hello everyone, welcome to 5th lecture for the course Applied Thermodynamics. We will continue with the fuels in combustion and today we will go for combustion equation. Myself Sumit Bardia, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Yatra. Today we will see symbols and molecular weights. Combustion equation under that, combustion of hydrogen, combustion of carbon, theoretical air and excess air, stoichiometric air fuel ratio, conversion of volumetric analysis to the mass analysis, it is also called as gravimetric analysis, and the last one, the conversion of gravimetric analysis to volumetric analysis. Before considering combustion problems, it is necessary to understand the construction and use of chemical formula. We all know that combustion is nothing but a chemical reactions. So before going for the combustion equations, we need to understand the symbols and the molecular weights of that symbols. So here the list is given of some important elements, compounds and gases. List that is hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, sulfur, water, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, methane gas, or it is also called as marsh gas, ethylene, ethane. So that list is required in order to go for the combustion equations. So molecular weight we have to know. For example, hydrogen having the molecular weight of 2, oxygen having a molecular weight of 32. Likewise, all elements have given its molecular weight. So we'll go with the combustion equations. In that, two categories are there, that is combustion of hydrogen and combustion of carbon. So we know that in steam power plant, fuel is burnt in order to get the heat energy that is used to convert water into steam, and further steam is utilized to drive the turbine, and ultimately we are getting an electricity from it. So combustion equations, in that combustion chamber, we know that is the fuel burning place. In the combustion chamber, proportionate masses of air and fuel enters where the chemical reaction takes place, and then the combustion products pass to the exhaust. By the conservation of mass, the flow of mass remains constant, but the reactants are chemically different from the products, and the products leave at a higher temperature. The total number of atoms of each element concerned in the combustion remains constant, but the atoms are rearranged into groups having different chemical properties. This information is expressed in the chemical equations that we are going to see further. The two sides of equation must be consistent, each having the same number of atoms of each element involved. The oxygen supplied, so oxygen is required for the combustion. Without oxygen, we can't get the heat energy from it, or burning will not be take place. The oxygen supplied for combustion is usually provided by atmospheric air, and it is necessary to use accurate and consistent analysis of air by mass as well as by volume. It is usual in combustion calculations to take air as 23.3% O2 and remaining is nitrogen by mass, and if you go for a volume, the 21% of oxygen and 79% of nitrogen. The small traces of other gases in dry air are included in nitrogen, which is sometimes called atmospheric nitrogen. So we'll see one by one combustion of hydrogen first. Some of the important combustion equations we are taking here, that is combustion of hydrogen first. So here the equation is written 2H2 plus O2 equal to 2H2O. So two molecules of hydrogen reacts with oxygen to get the water or H2O. So two volumes of H2, if we consider the volumes of H2, plus 1 volume of O2 will get 2 volumes of H2O. The H2O may be liquid or vapor depending upon the product has been cooled for the condensation. The proportion by mass, so we have seen the volume, now proportion of mass, 2H2 plus O2 to H2O, that is the equation. So what is the molecular weight of hydrogen? That is 2. O2, that is 32, will taken as 2 multiplied by 16, 1 O is 16, O2 will get 32, will get here 2 multiplied by 2, that is molecular weight of hydrogen, plus 16. So we'll get here 4 kg H2 plus 32 kg O2 equal to 36 kg of H2. If we simplify this, then when 1 kg of hydrogen reacts with 8 kg of oxygen, we will get 9 kg of water. Okay, so again H2 plus half O2 H2O. So if we divide by, if we take the volume of 1 here, 2 volumes, 1 volume, 2 volume, so here 1 volume, if we take the 1 volume of H2, we need to react with half O2 and we will get H2O. Okay, so the total volume of the product is only 2 volume, so therefore a volumetric contraction on combustion is there. Since the oxygen is accompanied by the nitrogen, if air is supplied for the combustion, so nitrogen should be included in the equation. So as nitrogen is inert as far as chemical reaction is concerned, so it will appear on both sides. So with 1 mole of oxygen, there are 79.21 moles of nitrogen. So if we go by volume, then 79% of nitrogen and 21% of oxygen is there. So 2H2, here the equation becomes, now where it is 2H2. So 2H2 plus O2, we need to add nitrogen here, 79 by 21 N2, 2H2O by 79 by 21 N2. So both sides we need to add nitrogen. So next is about the combustion of carbon. Again here the two categories are there. If complete combustion of carbon converted to carbon dioxide, and second category is incomplete combustion of carbon. Incomplete will occur due to insufficient supply of oxygen. If supply of oxygen will be less, there will be incomplete combustion. So similarly for carbon also, combustion of carbon, carbon plus O2 will get CO2. So carbon react with oxygen, we are getting carbon dioxide. Most important point is the combustion should be complete. And if we are including the nitrogen, we are adding both sides nitrogen, 79 by 21 N2, 79 by 21 N2. So if by volume we will consider, what is 0 volume C? So 0 means volume of solid is volume of carbon in the form of solid is negligible in comparison with that of gas. So 0 volume carbon plus 1 volume of O2 plus 79 by 21 volume N2. That will give you the 1 volume of CO2 and 79 by 21 volume of N2. If we considering by mass, 12 kg. So what is 12? Molecular weight of carbon. Oxygen 32 kg plus 79 by 21, 2 into 14 kg of nitrogen. So we are taking molecular weight here and calculating. Ultimately we are getting 1 kg of carbon when reacts with 8 by 3 oxygen plus 105.3 divided by 2 nitrogen, we will get 11 by 3 kg of CO2 plus 105.3 divided by 12 kg of nitrogen. So when the complete combustion will taking place, so this reaction will get. The second category, that is the incomplete combustion of carbon. So I already told you that the incomplete combustion of carbon occurs when there is an insufficient supply of oxygen. So if oxygen supply is less, the carbon dioxide will lead towards the carbon monoxide because the oxygen we are getting is less. So 2C plus O2, 2 carbon plus oxygen reacts, we will get 2CO. CO is carbon monoxide, which is very harmful. So due to incomplete combustion, we are getting, instead of CO2, we are getting CO, carbon monoxide. Including the nitrogen, we need to add 79 by 21 N2, both sides. By mass, again, molecular weight we need to add. And ultimately, we are getting 1 kg of carbon plus 4 by 3 kg of O2 plus 105.3 divided by 24 kg of N2. We will get 7 by 3 kg of CO plus 105.3 divided by 24 N2. That is same for it. Now, suppose if we supply oxygen, supply of oxygen available, then we can add up the oxygen in the equation, that is 2CO plus O2, O2 plus, if we add up oxygen in the equation, 2CO plus O2, 79 by 21 nitrogen, we will get here CO2. So by mass itself, if we put up the molecular weight, considering the molecular weight, here we will get the final equation as 1 kg CO plus 4 by 7 kg of O2 plus 105.3 divided by 56 kg of nitrogen. Here we will get 11 by 7 kg of CO2 instead of CO, CO2, because we are supplying the additional amount of oxygen to it. So we will get the here CO2 itself. If we supply more air, excess air, we will see the concept of excess air in the next point. 105.3 divided by 56 kg N2. So that reaction, these combustion equations we are getting when a particular hydrogen or carbon will react with the oxygen in order to get the heat energy, and how much amount of CO or CO2 will be our output that we are getting from this equation. Next point is about the theoretical air and excess air. So in order to complete the combustion, we need to supply the minimum amount of air which having a sufficient oxygen that may oxidize. It is called a theoretical air. When complete combustion is achieved with theoretical air, the products contain no oxygen. So we know that it is very difficult to achieve the complete combustion unless the amount of air supplied should be greater than the theoretical amount. Generally, it is 1.5 times the theoretical air. So we need to provide more 50%. Total will be the 150% theoretical air we need to supply in order to complete the combustion process. So complete combustion of methane, if we taken an example here, the complete combustion of methane with minimum amount of theoretical air, here we are considering 150%. So CH4 methane plus 2O2, we are already taken a reference of previous combustion equation. So methane plus 2O2, 2 here we are taking a 2 into nitrogen percentage, 79 by 21 into that will give you the CO2 plus H2O, 2 79 by 21 nitrogen. So here we are getting a CO2 if we are supplying 150% of theoretical air. So methane plus 2 into 1.5 O2. So here we are considering 1.5 O2 oxygen we are supplying, or air we are supplying to the combustion process. So we will get accordingly the percentage 1.5 nitrogen, and ultimately we will find here CO2 plus 2 H2O plus O2, 329 by 21 N2. So that much constituents of the output air outside after the combustion process that we are getting from this reaction. The amount of air actually supplied may also be expressed in terms of percent excess air. The excess air is amount of air supplied over and above the theoretical air. So we are going to supply more amount of air in order to complete the combustion process. So what amount? 50% excess air. So it is called 150% theoretical air means 50% excess air we are supplying in order to complete the combustion process. Next point is about the stoichiometric air fuel ratio. So what is meant by stoichiometric? Here we are calling as chemically correct mixture. So we know that for complete combustion we need oxygen, but how much amount of oxygen? So that sufficient amount of oxygen for complete combustion, that means it is a stoichiometric air fuel ratio. So stoichiometric mixture of air fuel is one that contains just enough oxygen for complete combustion of fuel. Here a weak mixture is one which has an excess air. So that will be weak mixture, and rich mixture is one which has a deficiency of air. The percentage of excess air, here actual air fuel ratio minus stoichiometric air fuel ratio divided by stoichiometric air fuel ratio, and mixture strength, stoichiometric air fuel ratio to the actual air fuel ratio. Now where A and F, that is nothing but air and fuel. For gaseous fuels, these ratios are expressed for solid and liquid fuels by volume, by mass. For gaseous fuel we are considering by volume, for solid and liquid fuels we are considering by mass. This air fuel ratio we are expressing. For boiler plant, the mixture is usually greater than 20% weak. For gas turbines, it can be much as 300% weak. So petrol engines have to meet various conditions of load and speed and operate over a wide range of mixture strength. So mixture strength, we know all IC engines. So we need to supply more strength, means mixture air fuel ratio strength should be richer in order to get more power. And for leaner mixture, again depending upon the speed and load, the variations will be there. So stoichiometric air fuel ratio will give you the optimum or chemically correct mixture that will give you the sufficient oxygen for complete combustion. The working value range between 80% and 120%. So 80% weak and 120% rich. So that the working value of the stoichiometric air fuel ratio. So the next point is about the conversion of volumetric analysis to gravimetric analysis. Now the question arises, how to convert volumetric to the mass analysis? So in order to convert into volumetric analysis of a mixture to the mass analysis, we need to use the relation, that is Mi equal to Ni mu I. So what is Mi here? M suffix I, mass of ith constituent. Ni is number of moles, and mu I is nothing but molar mass. So if we want to convert volumetric analysis to the weight, or it is also called as mass analysis, or it is also called as gravimetric analysis, we need to follow some steps. So first step is multiply the volume of each constituent by its molecular weight. So we need to multiply the volume of each constituent by its molecular weight. Second is add all these weights and divide each weight by the total of all and express it as percentage. So that these two steps we need to follow in order to convert the volumetric analysis. We will clear this by taking one example here. So example is given here, volumetric to mass analysis, percentage analysis of gas by volume. So by volume, that is given CO2 5.5%, CO 38.3%, CH 4.4%, hydrogen 52.8%, O2 0.1%, N2 2.9%. So we need to obtain the percentage analysis by mass. So conversion of volumetric to the mass analysis. So constituents we need to list out first. So constituent column, here constituents column CO2, CO, CH4, O2, H2, N2. So 6 constituents are given, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and percent volume is also given, that is Ni, we are calling as Ni, number of moles. So 5.5, 38.3, 0.4, 0.1, 52.8, 2.1. That is all given, constituents and its volume, that is given in terms of percentage. So the first step is multiply the volume of each constituents by its molecular weight. So molecular weight we need to list out first. Molecular weight. So CO2 molecular weight is 44, CO 28, CH4 16, oxygen 32, H2 2 and nitrogen 28. So mass Mi, we need to use that relation, Mi equal to Ni mu I. So volume, here the first step is multiply the volume of each constituents. This is the volume, this is volume column, multiply by its molecular weight. So we are getting here the list of multiplication, that is 242,1072 regarding, and the sum of all those is we are considering summation of Mi. Then the next step is add up these volumes and divide each volume by total of all and express it as a percentage. So what is the total of all? That is 1510.8 total. So Mi that is 242, if we considering the first CO2, 242 divided by summation of Mi, that is 1510.8, multiply by 100 to convert into percentage, we are getting here the conversion into mass analysis, that is 16.2%, 70.98, and likewise for all the constituents here listed. So total will be the 100%. So that will be the conversion. If we are considering the 5.5% by volume, it will be converted to 16.02% by mass. So that is the conversion procedure for volumetric to mass analysis. Then the next is reverse. That is how to convert the gravimetric analysis to volumetric analysis. So we need to do a reverse procedure for it, in which converts the mass fraction to mole fraction by using the relation. So previously the relation is Mi equal to Ni into mu I. Now here we need to go for Ni equal to Mi divided by mu I, which is a conversion of mass analysis to the volumetric analysis. It is generally applied to the gaseous fuels. Again, there are two steps to convert from gravimetric to volumetric. So divide the weight of each constituent by volume. Previously we are multiplying the weight of each constituent. Now we need to divide the weight of each constituent by its molecular weight and add up these volumes and divide each volume by the total of all and express it as a percentage. Again, we will take one example here. A gaseous mixture contains CO2 is given 16%, CO1%, O2 8% and N2 75% by mass. So we need to convert from gravimetric to volumetric analysis. So we are listed here constituents, four constituents are given. Its mass fraction is given, that is 16%, 1%, 8%, 75%. Molecular weight is given here 44, 28, 32, 28. Now we need to convert into mass to volume. So the relation will be Ni equal to Mi divided by mu I. So Mi is 16 divided by 44. So we will get 0.364. Likewise for all the four constituents, 28. 1 divided by 28, that is 0.035, 8 divided by 32, 0.25, 75 divided by 22, 28, 2.68. So summation of all, that is 3.327. Now number of moles we are calculated, Ni. Now convert into volume percentage, Ni divided by summation of Ni. So here we are already given in the steps. Add up all this and divide each volume by total of all. So divide each 0.364 divided by 3.3, that is coming 10.93%. 0.035 divided by 3.327, that will give you 1.040. likewise here the percentage all we have calculated for each constituents and we are getting 100% for it. So this is the method to convert gravimetric analysis to volumetric analysis. Both analysis we have seen and it is very easy to convert it. So we need to follow this procedure only. So today we will stop here. We will continue with the next points in the next lecture. Thank you so much.